Good day, viewers. Happy New Year. You are welcome to Development Platform, your number one flagship TV program on developmental activities. Focus today is on Federal Ministry of Mines and Steel Development, and our guest is Architect Olamilekan Adegbite. He is the Honorable Minister of Mines and Steel Development. Sit back as we take you through the corridors of this all-important ministry. I am Sonny Davids. We'll be back after this time out. Don't go away.
There is an absolute overhaul of the Ministry of Mines and Steel Development with the coming on board of Architect Olamilekan Adegbite and a mandate to diversify the economy, create jobs and earn revenue for government. The Ministry of Mines and Steel Development, formerly known as the Federal Ministry of Solid Minerals, was established by the government of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to ensure sustainable development of the nation's mineral sector. The ministry's major activities revolve around solid mineral exploration and exploitation within the country and the enforcement of laws and regulations guiding its activities. With a new roadmap for the growth and development of the nation's mining sector through diversifying the economy, creating jobs and earning revenue for government, Architect Olamilekan Adegbite is the Honorable Minister of Mines and Steel Development.
The ministry is responsible for the development of the mining sector in Nigeria and also to promote steel development in Nigeria as well. Those are the two major duties of the ministry. Now, mandates will evolve from administration to administration. The immediate mandate given to us by the president upon being sworn in, myself and the Honorable Minister of State, is essentially to use this sector to diversify the economy, to create jobs. When I came to office, there was a roadmap that we were following. But then there was this sad aspect that a lot of miners who come into the office, they mine bauxite. In Nigeria, bauxite is a mineral that's abundant in Nigeria. We have this bauxite in the Benue Trough around Nasarawa. We have it in Benue. We have it in Taraba, in these areas, and also we have a lot of it in Cross River State as well. So we mine bauxite locally, but unfortunately, bauxite is essentially used in the oil and gas industry. We are not able to use the bauxite mined locally in our oil and gas industry. The people who use bauxite in their drilling operations for the oil and gas industry, they necessarily need to go to DPR to get a permit to import bauxite. So from DPR, we were able to get the data that we spend about $300 million annually importing bauxite, essentially from Morocco. So I decided that, look, let's do this. So we got a bauxite consultant on board, somebody who had worked with bauxite all his life. We brought him on board to work with us and supported him. And we've been able to arrive at what we are able to do just about a month ago in Port Harcourt. We've been able to deliver made in Nigerian bauxite. Essentially, the problem was getting the bauxite from the mines to the market. That was a major problem. We had bauxite, but then to get it to acceptable level where the industry will accept it, that was the problem. So essentially what we did was that we facilitated the process. Government being the facilitator, but we are not an active player. So we got the people who mined the bauxite. We got people who had the mills, you know, who could mill to the standard required. Because what they use in the industry is what we call API, American Petroleum Institute Standard. So we got the people who could mill to about, I think it's about 300 microns or whatever. We got them. Then there was also a complaint about bagging. So we got entrepreneurs involved who invested money in bagging that went through rigorous tests until we were able to achieve the bag that we desire. So that process is what we did, and midwifed for sample sake, we did about 50 bags, which was launched in Port Harcourt.
In appraising the mining industry, This administration has made Nigeria's steel company a mining destination. Key minerals have been explored and exploited. This has brought about investors, hence increasing the country's gross domestic product, GDP. Dr. Uchechukwu Oga is the Minister of State for Mines and Steel Development.
Investors are beginning to look at Nigeria as a mining destination. Investors are beginning to look at Nigeria as potentials where certain key minerals can be exploited. We, like I said, in terms of revenue, in terms of the quantum of the minerals that are leaving Nigeria on a daily basis, in terms of contributing effectively to the gross domestic product of the Nigerian economy, when you look at it in terms of even creating more employment, because over the period, a lot of new companies have come into existence, and we've been able to create more jobs, and we've been able to give incentives to investors. And these are things that can attract, because you see, there's nothing like when a private sector person, an investor, wants to hear the language. And you can see myself and my brother, we are coming from the private sector, so they believe in us, and we say what we can do, and we do what we say. And that is what they want to hear, and that is what is bringing more investors and more effective development to the sector. So I believe that it is very, very important for you to know that the mining sector today in Nigeria has blossomed, has exploded, and a lot of people are, you know, developing interest.
Mine Diver Project is a World Bank project under the ministry, which links with the roadmap and enhances the mining sector's contribution to the economy by strengthening key government institutions, improving information infrastructure and knowledge, and fostering domestic investment in the sector. Engineer Salim Salem is the coordinator of this project.
Mineral Sector Support for Economic Diversification Project. What that means is that we are to support the sector for the growth and development. This current administration came on board and developed what they call the roadmap for the growth and development of mining sector. What that means is that because of the federal government's diversification policy to move from the monolithic economy, which was based on the petroleum oil, to other real sector, agriculture and minerals, mining particularly, there was a roadmap. The roadmap looked at what are the challenges of the sector that could hinder the progress towards achieving the diversification required. And it was discovered that some areas were identified that needs to be addressed. Some of them happens to be the enabling environment, lack of geodata generation, the legal regulatory issues, and etc. So when all this were articulated, there are some initiatives that were proposed. I mean, initiatives in form of projects or activities to be carried out to ensure that the roadmap is fully implemented. What the project does is to assist the sector in area of project implementation that will support the diversification project program of the federal government.
An important aspect that cannot be overlooked as regards revamping the Ministry of Mines and Steel Development is the effort made to have the Ajakota steel plant functional and fully operational. The present administration has an enormous will and drive to push this project to its full potential. This is evident by the non-relenting efforts of the Honorable Minister, Architect Olamilekan Adegbite, and Engineer Sumaila Abdul Akbar, who is the sole administrator of the steel company.
This plant was conceived by our forefathers about over four decades ago. It has the engineering unit, the production unit, the primary side, it has an estate, it has an airstrip, it has a river port. It's a complete industrial park in a particular zone. The challenge has been that this plant was never completed. The primary side of the plant was never completed. And a lot of effort before now to complete the plant. But the most recent and the most profound is the effort of the present administration, especially led by the tireless Honorable Minister of Mines and Steel, Architect Olamileko Adebite. He and the President led a delegation to Russia in 2019, where the President of Russia, Vladimir Putin, was engaged regarding the coming in of the original builder. This plant was built by the Russians. That engagement led to a formal agreement in principle that they are going to come to our aid to come and help us to complete, modernize, and operationalize the plant. Until the COVID came in. And you know, the COVID has been a challenge to manage because this is an engagement that required Nigerian and foreigners. We're still in COVID period, but even within the COVID period, a lot of engagement has been done online. The President has given approval. One of the things that is fundamental to bring back, to make Ajakuta functional, is to carry out the technical evaluation of the plant, which is referred to as technical audit. The technical audit will allow you to know what was installed, what was never installed, what has gone bad over years, and what is required to put it back in operation and modernize the plant. Internally, we have done the internal review when I arrived at Ajakuta. We've done a technical audit by myself and the technical staff with consultants from Russia. We have done technical evaluation internally, preparatory to the visit of the TP coming in soon.
Illegal mining and banditry has posed a challenge to the mining sector in recent times. In tackling this situation, there has been the provision of security by the ministry to ensure the protection of miners and their equipment. This has enhanced productivity within the sector. Professor Zakios Okpafunso, who is the Registrar of the Council of Nigerian Mining Engineers and Geoscientists, COMEC, the regulating body for all professionals and firms within the country, noted this challenge.
When I say we, I personalize that's COMEC, given back to by National Assembly via Act No. 40 of 1990, that set up this agency as the sole or apex regulatory agency of professionals in the Nigerian extractive industry. That's to separate us from others. And what does that mean when you say extractive industry? You are basically talking of professionals who are engaged in adding value to natural resources that are born out of the earth, be it solid minerals, be it petroleum, be it gas, be it water, be it sand, clay. The list goes on. So what you take out of the grant, use like that, or add value to it, and become useful to a human being. That's what the government wants this body to regulate. But the issue of banditry came in, spread its tentacle to all over the country, carry along with kidnappings and a lot of other armed robberies and whatever you call it. Then there is no way you expect the mining industry to remain the same. But thank God, the effort the government is making to make sure that at least the mining sites are safe. And one of the wonderful methods, Zamfara State and a few, and part of Kaduna and all of that, shut down the GSM. And let's see exactly what's going to happen. Because you don't carry out mining activity in the cities. They are in the rural area. This is where operation takes place. just as affecting our farm, it's also affecting our mine sites. Much as I said, there is no big mines. We also have these artisanal mines. They are there. They are not in Abuja town, Abuja city. They are not in the Badon or Enugu city. They are there where the farms are. So much is affected our food production. It's also affected the issue of mining. But government has taken practical steps. They have pumped money that most of us can read in paper and can witness. They have acquired technology from outside Nigeria that is helping to minimize that. And the moment the mining areas are safer, then I can guarantee you that the ministry will do more than what we are doing now. The minister has said data without number, because then the miners will be protected. Then you can move equipment the way you want to move it. Then Kume can go around and harass the legal miner. And then foreigners, including Chinese and all other that are coming here. You remember the story of Oshun, some of them were arrested. I think the ministry is handling that. Because we don't, you see, banditry, terrorism, no boundary. They come from different, it doesn't know your color.
In order to diversify and move away from over-dependence on oil, the Director General of the Mining Cadastral Office, Engineer Obadiah Nkom, noted that more funding is required in the sector. With time and consistency, mineral discoveries will be made and diversification in the country's economy is achieved and increased.
We have an advantage of geology. It does not even respect boundaries, whether it is Kogi or FCT or Oshun or Zamfara or anywhere. It's uniformly scattered, and that is why we have a lot of abundance of these mineral resources. We are just at an advantage, and I can tell you that we are barely scratching the surface. And that is why there is a need for funding, more funding. And funding is because it has a long gestation period. There are some projects that when they give you billions at the beginning of the year, at the end of the year they say, hey, how much have you made out of the billions? Mining is not like that. Mining is like, let me call it, planting a stone in the ground. And then you come back after 1 year, after 2 years. How old is the earth itself? You must be able to now look at, and it has not concluded. You still find discoveries of minerals. If you go to Geological Survey, my brother there, he will tell you there are discoveries every day. Places that initially you think there is no gold, you find it. Go to my brother too in the NMPC, the GMD. They made discoveries in the oil and gas. In places initially, they thought there was no oil and gas. So you find out discoveries of minerals is like every day. So the diversification of the sector, looking at it globally, what is the future of our oil? What is the future minerals? Go to conferences now, which we just came back. We are talking about the future minerals. You know? Initially, when you find some systems, we are talking about electric cars. Some countries have already have legislation that from so year they won't be using petrol vehicles. Are we aligning ourselves? Don't we have these minerals? What of some of these areas? I don't want to go into policies. Government is doing a lot into the diversification of our Jakuta and so on and so forth. So at the end of the day, when you look at it, you now realize that we have these minerals. They are all there. And government, through the Nigerian Integrated Mineral Exploration Project, chaired and supervised by the minister and all the relevant departments, a lot of work has been done. Government is funding it. The first phase and second phase is on and concluded. Reports have been given for some of them. And at the end of the day, we are all integrated towards making sure that we identify where these minerals are and be able to now package it and bring in the needed big players who have this money there. And then there are some minerals that when you say you have them, nobody will be bothered. But there are some that, because that's why they call them future minerals, that you find people are so much interested in them.
Geological investigation, analysis, production of geological, geochemical, and geophysical maps, which are necessary for the development of the mining industry in the country, is done by the Nigerian Geological Survey Agency. This agency serves as a national depository of all geological information, putting out all information from the geological industries for public good and consumption, as provided by either individuals or companies involved. Dr. Abdulrazak Garba is the Director General of this agency.
Nigerian Geological Survey was established precisely more than 100 years ago, that is in 1919. But the precursor to this Nigerian Geological Survey started with the mineral surveys of the Northern Protectorate and Southern Protectorate. This mineral survey has been in existence right from the pre-colonial era. And merging them together in 1990 led to the beginning of geological surveys of Nigeria. And basically at that point in time, during this period, the Europeans were looking for minerals to prosecute the World War. So in this process, they were surveying parts of the country. So that marked the beginning of actual surveys, that's geological surveys in Nigeria. Now, if I have to go further, Nigeria Geological Survey has given birth to so many institutions. The Public Works Department that later became the Ministry of Works started from Geological Surveys of Nigeria. However, being an agency commenced with the enactment of an act which was signed into law by the National Parliament, that is the National Assembly, on the 22nd of May 2006. That led to Nigerian Geological Survey being an agency. Prior to this time, we had been a department in the Ministry of Mines and Steel Development. We carry out geological investigation, analysis. We do what we call production of geological map, geophysical map, geochemical map. All these maps are necessary for development of a country. We also serve as a national depository of all geological information. What this means is you have companies working, you have individuals working. All their information, they are supposed to remit it to us, then we keep record of this. The essence of doing this is to provide, to put up all this information for public good. So basically, we do also what we call engineering geology. You can see companies coming up, constructing here and there, but you do construction on the surface of the ground. We provide this information because lack of this knowledge also has its own consequences. So you can see that what geological survey and geologists do straddles every aspect of our life, both health, in construction, education, so many things. Geology forms the basis of it.
A major challenge facing the mining sector is the issue of funding. Funding is required for the exploration of minerals and acquisition of data. Though the present government has supported the sector greatly, much is still needed to carry out mineral exploration as it is a work in progress. There's also the need to build up human capacity. The Honorable Minister has ensured the training of staff to achieve expertise in their different fields.
There is an absolute overhaul of the Ministry of Mines and Steel Development with the coming on board of architect Olamilekan Adegbite and a mandate to diversify the economy, create jobs and earn revenue for government.
Wow, your guess is as good as mine. Federal Ministry of Mines and Steel Development, and an institution, if well governed, Nigeria will be a better place to be. Well, this is about the size of the package for today on Development Platform. Your organization can also participate on this program, and you can also call us for professional media coverage for your events and ceremonies at the cost of your budget. For sponsorship, adverts, and other inquiries, kindly take notes of the contacts on the screen. Don't forget to subscribe, like, follow us on our social media handles. Until we come your way again, I am Sonny David. Bye for now.